Use the means of today to reach the people of today.
The Church Speaks, an episode where the Holy Father, the Pope, and the Bishops of the Philippines speaks about their apostolic letters and exhortations to all Catholic Christians.
Pope Francis dedicates his first prayer message of 2022 to combating religious discrimination and persecution, reminding us that religious freedom is not limited to freedom of worship, but is tied to fraternity. How can we allow that in this society, which is so civilized, there are people who are persecuted simply because they publicly profess their faith? How is it possible that many religious minorities currently suffer discrimination or persecution? Catholic Charity Aid to the Church in Need, which is supporting this month's message, report that worldwide religious freedom is violated in one out of every three countries, comprising around two-thirds of the total world population. More than 646 million Christians, ACN reports, live in countries that does not respect religious freedom. Pope Francis emphasizes that religious freedom is not limited to freedom of worship, but makes us appreciate others in their differences and recognize them as true brothers and sisters. Even substantial differences such as religious differences should not obscure the great unity of being brothers and sisters. Let us choose the path of fraternity, because either we are brothers and sisters or we are loose. We shall continue the Pope's catechesis next Sunday.
Oratio Imperata. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other to see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection. O Holy Mother of God, do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Raphael the Archangel, pray for us. San Roque, pray for us. San Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. San Pedro Calungsod, pray for us. Saint Paul the Apostle, pray for us.
This Holy Mass is brought to you in collaboration with Ricardo O. Santiago Sr., Steve G. Santiago and Family, Stu and Nancy Santiago and Family, Stephen and Joy Santiago and Family, Salome Santiago Lim and Benedicto Lim Jr. and Family, Sunny Boy and Luella Santiago and family, Fancy May D. Imbong, Mercy Evangelista and family, St. John Paul II College of Davao, Royal Bread House Incorporated, Tat and Gigi Cornell and family, Teresita Villa Abrile, T. Linao Trucking Services, Mr. and Mrs. Protasio and Fe Takandong and family, Davao Durian Laundry Services Company, Sheridan, JDB Diversified Incorporated, Melvin E. Aviles, Willens Food House, Mr. and Ms. Lucas B. Datoy and family, Jess and Amelia Dison, Gus and Sophie, Mrs. Ampi Casas and family, Adolfo and Malu Ato, Purita and Lorenzo and family.
Offering of the Holy Mass. Accept, Most Holy Trinity, this sacrifice fulfilled at one time by the Divine Word, and now renewed on this altar through the hands of your priest. I unite myself to the intentions of Jesus Christ, priest and victim, that I may be entirely offered for your glory and for the salvation of all people. Through Jesus Christ, with Jesus Christ, and in Jesus Christ, I intend to adore your eternal majesty, to thank your immense goodness, to satisfy your offended justice, and to beseech your mercy for the Church, for my dear ones, and for myself. Amen.
We pray for the intentions of our regular sponsors, choir members, donors, offerers, and volunteers of this Holy Mass, especially the sponsoring group. Engineer Ernesto and Erlinda Aguilar and family, Mercy Evangelista and family, St. John Paul II College of Davao, Bonifacio and Lilia Mabilin and family. Thanksgiving intentions, Nira Tumalip, Anonymous Magdalena Cocam, Carlos Tan and family, Salvador family. Good health, Mercy Evangelista, Ernesto and Erlinda Aguilar, Lita Montalban, Nelio and Evelyn de la Peña, Lilia and Bonifacio Mabilin, Ronel Mabilin, Vivian Cam. Birthday intentions, Ernest Patrick Aguilar, December 15, Evangeline Cedeño, December 17, Ryan Aguilar, December 29, Rhea Aguilar Polinar, January 13, Esther Valmonte, Anna Mikanag, Minda Neri, Fortune Castillo, Flora Exala, Joy Alvarez, Jess Dison, Betty Soriano. Recovery and Healing of Imel Sison, Regina Cispedes, Julie Sanz, Linda Torrejos, Rudy Torrejos, Martin Castillo. For the eternal repose of Glaceria, Rodolfo, Bernardo, Milagros, Luciana, Jermin, Erlinda, Claudio, Thelma, Marutas, Julio, Minandro Sr., Anastasio, Filipa, Eduardo, Ernesto Sr., Jessica, Manuel, Renerio Sr., Conrada, Adelaida, Leoncio, Damaso, Rosita, Lourdes, Floro, Linda, Luga, Death Anniversary, Christine, Roger, Roberto, Marcelina, Elizabeth, Almacchio, Lourdes, Feliciano, Francisco Jr., Loreto, Senforoso, Salem, Estefania, Jaime, and those who died with COVID-19, all the souls in purgatory, all deceased benefactors, sponsors, and cooperators, the Pauline's Media Mission.
Lord and Father, God without end and almighty, through your grace, you gave us strength and help in our weakness. In your mercy, touch your sick people. Deliver them from their sicknesses and restore their good health, so that assured of your goodness and love, they will praise and thank you in your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Brothers and sisters, Jesus' baptism in the Jordan River is the second epiphany, the second manifestation of his identity and mission. His mission will also entail taking upon himself the weight of mankind's sinfulness, as foretold in the last of the servant's songs. Jesus' baptism reminds us of our own baptism when the Father pronounced over us the most splendid sentence we will ever hear. You are my beloved son, my beloved daughter. It is this unparalleled dignity which entitles us to participate in this Eucharist. Let us do so with gratitude and love. The presider of this Mass is Father Manny Perez, S.J., Society of Jesus Fathers, Ateneo de Davao University. The choir doing this Mass is the St. Therese Canticles of Praise Choir, Carmelite Monastery, Lanang, Davao City. Let us joyfully celebrate the banquet of love. Please stand as we start the Holy Mass.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
It's really a privilege and honor to be here on this last day of Christmas. This is the time that we can still greet other Merry Christmas. This is the time that we still have our Christmas symbols, particularly the Belen. And so next year, we again look forward to the celebration of Christmas. So Christmas this year is very an event that's very, very, very full of blessings. And we give thanks to the Lord for the gift of Jesus Christ that has given us this Christmas season. And so my brothers and sisters, as we gather together to acknowledge our sins, let us prepare ourselves and celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what you have done, in what you have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in Christ had been baptized in the River Jordan, and as the Holy Spirit descended upon him, solemnly declare him your beloved Son. Grant that your children, and by adoption, reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, may always be well-pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
What we are about to hear is the first of the four songs of the Servant of the Lord. All Christian generations have seen in him a prophetic figure of Jesus of Nazareth, the one in whom alone the Father is fully pleased. The first reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one with whom I am pleased, upon whom I have put my spirit. He shall bring forth justice to the nation, not crying out, not shouting, not making his voice heard in the street. A bruised reed he shall not break, and a smoldering wick he shall not quench, until he establishes justice on the earth. The coastlands will wait for his teaching. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand. I formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light for the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from confinement, and from the dungeon those who live in darkness. The word of the Lord. The voice of the Lord is over the waters, the Lord over vast waters. The voice of the Lord is mighty, the voice of the Lord is majestic. The God of glory thunders, and in his temple all say, glory. The Lord enthroned above the floods, the Lord is enthroned as King forever.
The passage we are about to hear contains the beginning of the discourse of Peter in the house of the Roman centurion Cornelius. This text is used in today's feast because of its reference to Jesus, whom God anointed with the Holy Spirit and power. The second reading.
From the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak to those gathered in the house of Cornelius, saying, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears Him and acts uprightly is acceptable to Him. You know the word that He sent to the Israelites as He proclaimed peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. What has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O
Lord. The people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, "I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire." After all the people had been baptized, and Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, heaven was opened and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove, and a voice came from heaven, "You are my beloved Son. With you I am well pleased." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So still, the last day of Christmas, we can still greet each other, Merry Christmas. And today is the feast of the baptism of the Lord. The feast of the baptism is part of the Christmas season. It is the last day of Christmas. And so that's our readings and gospel for today. The feast of baptism of our Lord presents us with the third epiphany, or manifestation of our Lord. The first epiphany being the nativity of our Lord. We are all familiar with that. And the second, the one we celebrated last Sunday, the Feast of the Magi. The baptism of Jesus was the moment when he passed from a relatively obscurity life in the village in Nazareth into the public stage of his mission of proclaiming the kingdom of God. We are brought to the banks of the River Jordan, somewhere north of Jerusalem, where John the Baptist had begun his ministry. John the Baptist was preaching in the wilderness and was baptizing all those who would respond to his message of repentance. I would like to emphasize the message of repentance was the message of the baptism of John the Baptist. The purpose of his ministry of preaching and baptism was to direct the people toward Jesus, who would baptize them with the Holy Spirit. Okay, that's the mission of John, and it's very clear to him. Hindi siya nang ago na eksena. Alam niya na his mission is to direct the people to Jesus. Okay, and this Jesus would make the baptism of the Holy Spirit. His was the baptism of water, the water of repentance. The scriptures tell us that Jesus came from Galilee to River Jordan to be baptized by John the Baptist. Medyo malayo, ah, Galilee to the River Jordan. Jesus subjects himself to the simple act of repentance and is baptized by his own cousin, John the Baptist. Baptism is meant as an acknowledgement of sin, and Jesus, we know that, was totally sinless. He had no need of repentance or forgiveness. When Jesus came out of the water after his baptism, the heavens opened and the Holy Spirit descends upon him in the form of the dove. There is also a voice of the Father that comes from the cloud. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. The baptism of Jesus at the hands of John the Baptist is recounted in some detail in the Gospel of Matthew, told more briefly in the Gospel of Mark, mentioned in detail in the Gospel of Luke, and unrecorded, though probably presumed, in the Gospel of John. In all four accounts, the anointing of Jesus with the Spirit and the declaration of his sonship is directly linked to his baptism. Mark and Luke tells us only that Jesus was baptized in the Jordan by John. But Matthew adds that both the Baptist was hesitant and felt unworthy. Ayaw talaga niya nung una. He feels unworthy to do it. Jesus, however, urges compliance with the call of God to fulfill all righteousness. Mark suggests that Jesus was baptized during the ministry of John to all the people, while the structure of the text in Luke indicates that the baptism of Jesus by John indicates that the culmination of John's ministry, meaning that after all the people had been baptized, then Jesus was baptized. That was the culmination. The fourth evangelist says only that John saw Jesus coming to him, and there follow certain Christological declarations by John. The fundamental feature of all the narratives is that on the occasion of his baptism, Jesus is anointed by the Spirit. This is what happened in the baptism of Jesus. Jesus is anointed by the Spirit, thus inaugurating the ministry of Jesus, the start of his public ministry. St. Paul, in the second reading, tells us of our own baptism. I'm sure you cannot remember your own baptism. You were very small then. And our own baptism is the gift of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. He reminds us that the Lord has come to give us salvation and give us
through the sign of baptism. Paul sees himself as the steward of God's grace. The mystery he has received by revelation is to hand over to others. The opening words of today's gospel tells us that John the Baptist was proclaiming the baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. It is important not to misunderstand the meaning of these words. It will be quite wrong to think that people simply had to come for baptism to the river for all their sins to be wiped out. That would be a little than a superstition. Okay? So, what is the meaning of the baptism then? The baptism itself was a symbolic act that had to be accompanied by inner change. Inner change. The word for repentance here is metanoia in Greek, meaning a change of heart. It implies a radical change in the way we look at the meaning and the purpose of life and how we live that life ourselves. It calls for more than what is connoted by the repentance, which we normally understand as being sorry. Hindi lamang basta sorry. It calls for total recognition of one's attitude so that such errant or hurting behavior would simply disappear in one's life. Metanoia is much more than feeling sorry for something we have done. Metanoia is much more than feeling sorry. At the same time, forgiveness of sins is more than just God's wiping away our guilt and the threat of punishment that our sins might involve. In a sense, our sins can never be wiped out. The damage they do often lasts for a very long time and cannot be undone. In order to understand today's feast and what took place in the River Jordan, we have to go far beyond seeing Jesus' baptism as a matter of dealing with sinfulness. Baptism, as in true of all the sacraments, is not an isolated ritual. It takes place in the context of our whole life and the life of the community. We become not passively but actively member of Christ's body, or the body of Christ, or if you want, the mystical body of Christ. As today's reading tells us, the sacrament of baptism is insufficient to save us. It's not enough to save us. We must live our faith in Christ by obeying the commandments of God. That's how we are saved. This is achieved by shining our life toward others as a light in the world. And so as the three kings have gone home, and so as the stars have disappeared already from Jerusalem, as the shepherds have gone, the work of Christmas remains. And what is that work of Christmas? Basically, that is the work of baptism. To feed the hungry, to clothe the naked, to visit the sick, to give food to the poor and those who need food, especially those who are victims of the typhoon. And lastly, the work of Christmas is to sing that song that we used to sing in our lives, to praise God and to praise all the wonderful things that He has done for us. Merry Christmas to all of you. And until next year, we will again say to each other, Merry Christmas, and sing our Christmas songs. Let us profess our faith all together.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
You recall Jesus' formal investiture as the servant of the Lord. He will take upon himself the sins of the world. With gratitude for his generosity, let us pray, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. For the whole body of believers, and especially their leaders, may they be the humble and faithful servants of the Lord in the world of today. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the newly baptized, especially those who are adults, may they treasure the presence of the Holy Spirit in their hearts and always live as beloved children of the Father. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who have forgotten the meaning and the importance of their baptism, may the Holy Spirit renew in them the fruits of this presence and make them once again active members of the Church. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the poor, the sick, and the jobless, may they find in the Christian community the support and help they need. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all of us gathered here, may we always be aware that we too are God's adopted children and please him at all times. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all the dying, the elderly, the disabled persons, and the lonely, that they may always pray to you for their needs, believing that you will not abandon them. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all those who have fallen asleep in death, trusting in your mercy to the glory of the resurrection, especially the victims of COVID-19, the deceased members of the sponsors, benefactors, and cooperators of the Pauline's media mission. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord Jesus, at your baptism, you accepted to carry the crushing burden of our sins. May we lighten that burden by honoring the commitments of our baptism. We ask this through you, who are our brother and Lord. Amen.
In our hearts, we kneel down and pray.
Yeah.
Pray, my dear brethren, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
You will accept the sacrifice of our hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our ruin and good of all His holy church.
Accept, Lord, the offerings we have brought to honor the revealing of your beloved Son, so that the oblation of your faithful may be transformed into the sacrifice of Him who willed in His compassion to wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's really right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the waters of the Jordan you revealed with signs and wonders the new baptism, so that through the voice that came down from heaven, we might come to believe in your word dwelling among us, and by the Spirit's descending in the likeness of a dove, we might know that Christ, your servant, has been anointed with the oil of gladness, and sent to bring the good news to the poor. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Romulo, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Apostles, with Saint Joseph, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. May we merit to be co-heirs eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God. Of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
For those who cannot receive Holy Communion, we pray the Spiritual Communion.
Jesus, Master, you assure me, I am the life. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood will have eternal life. In baptism and in the Sacrament of Reconciliation, you have communicated to me this life of yours. Now, you nourish it by making yourself my food. Take my heart. Detach it from the vain things of the world. With all my heart, I love you above all things, because you are infinite good and eternal happiness. Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly entreat your mercy, O Lord, and that faithfully listening to your only begotten Son, we may be your children in name and in truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kayusahan, giya sa atong liturhikanong pag-alagad. Inubanan sa pagpamalandong o tigpasayon nga gikan sa mga pare sa tandag. Diocese. Ugula matagbulan, kahiusahan o available din sa Paulines Media Center, Bolton Street, Davao City. Tag 70 ang kopya.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.